Smallpox and Impetigo, Chickenpox that isn't stable, HSVs, a joy to eye, these Scabies and poison ivy, Coxsackie and Rickettsia, Molluscum and Eczema, on your differential for vesicular rash. Sick germs when the slithering pass. Sick germs when the slithering pass. Sick germs when the slithering pass. On your differential for vesicular rash. Young kid, with no particular pass. Brought in by his mother for vesicular rash. Mild fever, oh no, he's moping around the house. Complaining of a sore throat from ulcers in his mouth and painful blisters on the palms and the soles of his feet, which he gave his sister over the week. It's summertime, so they were hoping that we could find what underlies his ulcers that week. Mom got happy cause I got the nitis. Hand, foot and mouth, Coxsackie virus. Don't trip cause it's off in control with Motrin and resolves on its own. Next kid's a little different with a similar rash. Fluid filled vesicles transmitted real fast. It started on his abdomen and on to his chest, to his arms, to his legs, to his head and his neck, except it spared the palms and soles. Dew drops on the petal of a blossom rose. All these lesions in various stages, even crusted over after drainage. Mom's asked about the perks of aspirin, but in chicken pox, adverse reactions that might involve the liver and brain. So give Tylenol when your kid got pain, I explain. Now I'm on to the next one. A young mom who's alarmed by a stepson. He had a fever, now he's covered in blisters. The weird thing is, none of them differed. So I thought, where have I seen you before? What rash is vesicular and uniform? What rash in particular, if not controlled, can even affect the palms and soles? So I rolled him towards isolation. They call pharmacy for vaccinations. I told mom, I know it's a long shot, but your son probably got smallpox and Impetigo, chickenpox that isn't stable, HSVs, a joy to eye, these Scabies and poison ivy, Coxsackie and Rickettsia, Molluscum and Eczema, on your differential for vesicular rash. Sick germs when the slithering pass. Sick germs when the slithering pass. Sick germs when the slithering pass. On your differential for vesicular rash. Smallpox and Impetigo, chickenpox that isn't stable, HSVs, a joy to eye, these Scabies and poison ivy, Coxsackie and Rickettsia, Molluscum and Eczema, on your differential for vesicular rash. Now the ED's packed in fat, cause clinic style, a young kid with a rash like chickenpox, but something in the history's not sitting right. Exterminator recently to get rid of mice. Now a house that got a lot of mouse traps, raise a red flag for one that'll bounce back. So I lean on my physical exam and I found an S-car that was inches from his hand. It's planned, well partly cause these vesicles are Rickettsia Akari, transmitted from the bite of a mite. Gave them doxy promptly, then slide to my right. Mom came here with two kids, it's unclear what they have. From daycare, the truth is they may share the same rash. Was bullious and wet, while the other was less purulent and left a honey-colored crust. Both started near the lip line, but with time shift sides, wandered to the midline and even on the kid's thighs. But it's fine, the story is notorious for the bacteria staph aureus, better known as Impetigo. There are two types, but good thing it isn't fatal. So here on in, they'll begin on mupirocin, then Clinda or Bactrim if still virulent. Next to her was a kid with asthma, and a rash that emerged in a particular pattern. Used to be on his cheeks, now it's in every crease. Even itches asleep so much more that it weeps, and the cycle repeats, therefore never done. Allergies and itchy rash sound like eczema. Cetaphil body wash is a fair choice, along with moisturizer and topical steroids. For the face, there's a nod, a Cinelar. Every other place, Lidex, a Kenalog. And that'll calm most eczema flares. Follow up with Derm for additional care. Smallpox and Impetigo, chickenpox that isn't stable, HSVs, a joy to eye, these Scabies and poison ivy, Coxsackie and Rickettsia, Molluscum and Eczema, on your differential for vesicular rash. Sick germs when the slithering pass. Sick germs when the slithering pass. Sick germs when the slithering pass. On your differential for vesicular rash. Smallpox and Impetigo, chickenpox that isn't stable, HSVs, a joy to eye, these Scabies and poison ivy, Coxsackie and Rickettsia, Molluscum and Eczema, on your differential for vesicular rash. I flashed a keen glance, linear like a scratch from a tree branch. Any chance your kid's been at a camp? Now that you mention it, we visited her grams, living on a lot of land. With that in mind, Graham said, if I find leaves a three, let it be. Leaves a five, let them thrive. I replied, that's wise, cause the rash on your boy's likely due to poor poison ivy that leads to your usual boil from a reaction to the plant's urushiol oil. To counteract it, we use topicals and Benadryl, but if serious, cortical steroids in a pill. Brother and a sis and his mother got the itch. Small papules exist that are covering the wrist, belt line, abdomen, and even finger webs. Worse at night while in the bed, what's lingering sounds like their apartment's compromised by the mic, sarcoptic scabia. While you lay in bed, asleep under sheets, it burrows through your skin and lays eggs underneath. Only if your skin's defenseless. That's why we prescribe 5% permethrin, which inhibits your sodium channels, paralyzed minutes after you lotion your ankles. Young kid Matthew with flesh color papules. Mom asked, do you think it's from the bathroom? It's more likely he got it from the classroom. Skin to skin contact is how it's passed through. The pox virus pursues a victim, then starts hiding from its immune system. Pearly white papules appear near the armpit, or dome shaped ones, both which are harmless. It self resolves in 2 to 6 months, but there are treatments that I could think of. If cryo don't work, there are still some options like cantharidin, a podophyllotoxin. Last but not least was a high school wrestler, the beast of the east, known for breaking the records. A while back he noticed a vesicular patch on the side of his neck, maybe a stinger, a scratch. He thought nothing of it and figured it passed, but instead it lingered and grew bigger in fact. And the pain stung worse than a scorpion. That's cause he had herpes gladiatorium. All in all though, he was fortunate, got Valtrex, then won the tournament. Now he's on lifelong HSV prophylaxis, anytime he wrestles, including practice. Smallpox and Impetigo, chickenpox, it isn't stable. HSV's a joy to ID, Scabies and poison ivy, Coxsackie and Rickettsia, Molluscum and Eczema. On your differential for vesicular rash. Sick germs when the slithering pass. Sick germs when the slithering pass. Sick germs when the slithering pass. On your differential for vesicular rash. Smallpox and Impetigo, chickenpox, it isn't stable. HSV's a joy to ID, Scabies and poison ivy, Coxsackie and Rickettsia, Molluscum and Eczema. On your differential for vesicular rash.